I'm Cameron Pascoe. I'm an actor, artist, bartender. At the moment, a couple of things. I just finished a script, a horror movie that we're trying to get produced with a couple of friends of mine. And I'm designing a bar in the CBD at the moment. So the cocktail program, the wine list, training, all the things that go into making a place kind of operational. My motivation comes from a few things. First, one of my best friends is involved in it, and you've got to support your friends. And she saw me at a dance floor at a wedding after a few too many wines and thought he'd be really good for this. But look, I think cancer, or you know, it affects everybody. So there's, whether you're suffering from it or suffering because of it, you're a family member or just a loved one, someone who's by the bed, you know, I think all those people need support. I think it's important to think that as a society, we don't forget those people. You know, just because they're sick doesn't mean they're forgotten. As a people, we should be more empathetic. So I think it's really important to if you are able to give or are able to participate, then you should. Purely from the point that, you know, people need help, and there's nothing wrong with giving help at any time. My dance part is Veronica Clavijo, and I've said that wrong, but it's close. She's awesome, actually. She's a little actress too, so we have a great little repartee. It's really, really fun and expressive, and we're just having a lot of fun with it. So it's more about us smiling and then figuring out what we can do with the dance, and she's really patient. I think you can expect to see just two people having a really, really good time. Nobody said that because we're dancing for cancer counts that we have to be morbid. We should be smiling. We should be enjoying what we're doing. You'll see me fumbling and stuffing it up, and Veronica dancing amazingly to cover up everything that I do wrong. But most of all, you see, like, I've never met her before. We've just become really good friends. And I think that's, you know, I met somebody new, made a great friend, and I'm having a really good time. And I think that's what you'll see.
Good morning. We've talked the whole night through.
Good morning.
Good morning to you. Good morning. Good morning. It's great to stay up late. Good morning. Good morning to you.
When the band began to play, the stars were shining bright.
Now the milkman's on his way. It's too late to say good night.
So good morning. Good morning. Sunbeam. We'll soon smile through. Good morning, good morning to you and you and you and you.
Good morning, good morning. We've gabbed the whole night through. Good morning, good morning to you.
Nothing could be grander than to be in Louisiana
in the morning. In the morning, it's great to stay up late. Good morning, good morning to you.
Might be just as zippy if we was in Mississippi.
When we left the movie show, the future wasn't bright, but came the dawn. Show goes on and I don't want to say goodnight.
Don't say good morning.
Good morning.
Rainbows are shining through.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Bonjour.
Monsieur.
Buenos dias.
Muchas frias.
Buongiorno.
Buongiorno.
Good morning.
Guten Morgen.
Good morning to you.
Broadway, look out. You nailed that. How did that feel?
Fantastic, mate. Yeah, it felt really good. Thank you.
How did it look?
Looked amazing. How much help did you have?
130% help. No, she's been amazing. It's been a great journey.
He's amazing.
It's good, like, to do stuff that just makes you smile.
And you made us smile. Go and see you up in Mandy up in the green room.
We have Cameron and Veronica. Come here, you gorgeous things. How much did you love that?
Just, I really loved it. We were just saying how much fun it was, you know, and it was over so quick. A really great time.
Because you're a performer and you're used to being on TV, how does it compare coming out in front of a live audience like that?
Nothing gives you the energy that a live audience does. So we're like seeing happy smiles, and they're all so supportive, so you can't do anything wrong.
You can't, exactly. And look, you handled your hat well. You handled it as good as you handle your cocktail shaker. You thought I was going to say something else then, didn't you?
Yeah.
No, I'm not that rude. No. And now your mother has a dance school, is that right, Veronica?
That's correct. She does have a dance school in Marrickville. It's a bit far from here, but...
And she wants Cam to join?
She wants Cameron to start the intermediate advanced ballet class.
The ballet class! Who wants to see Cameron in tights? I do! Yes, I do.
It's not going to happen.
It's not going to happen. We'll see.
I haven't got the ass for tights.
You haven't got the ass for tights? Well, let us be the judge of that. And let the judges tell us what their scores are for you guys tonight.
Scotty Bennett's
8.
8. Hey. Anthony Minicello.
That's another 8 for me.
Wow. Chris Bamford.
7.
Sally Betts. 7.
Wow,
well,
fantastic
done.
Score. You're happy with that?
Yeah, that's great. Thank you very much for that.
Well done.